This is a normal mains connected grounded power outlet for 230 volts, 10 amps here in Finland. And the keen-eyed viewer might notice a problem with it, and that's that there's no electricity coming out. So, it's about 8 in the morning, and I was about to have breakfast, but the power went out about an hour ago, so I figured I would try a little experiment, and that would be an inverted morning meal. So, what you will need in order to perform this experiment at home, if you so wish, is a microwave oven, some suitable morning breakfast, this is a frozen pie, some means of making hot water for your coffee, and in my case, a coffee pot, complete with coffee there at the bottom. Now, this is a 2.5 kilowatt kettle, and I only have a 1.5 kilowatt inverter, so you may or may not also need a variac. And I've got a pretty big one at that. And of course, you'll need a rather oversized battery bank and a rather shabby inverter. So, right now I've got the microwave hooked straight to the inverter. I don't know if that's going to work or if I'm going to need the variac. So in the name of science, we'll try and pair up. There we go. So, this should take about 4 minutes. We'll get the full 800 watts, but just adjust the duty cycle anyway. That doesn't sound very good. I think we better use the variac. Okay, take two. I've got my variac set to about 180 volts. And the microwave doesn't seem to work. Ah, there we go. Too much power. And there we go. We can't seem to go much above 190 volts on the variac without the inverter shutting off due to overload. Since this microwave transformer coupling is very reactive for some reason, I can't fathom why. So we better give it some extra time. Hope it's getting warm at all. I don't even know if the magnetron works. Oh, it's getting warm. Beautiful. I think this ought to make my breakfast hot. 116 amps. I can taste the electrons already. Seems nice and cooked all the way through. Bit chill in the bottom, but that's normal. It seems to be more evenly heated than usual, even since we have a slightly lower power magnetron than normal. The pie had more time to soak up the delicious radio waves. So let's try a piece. That's alright. A bit crispier than usual, but it's alright. So, while this pie takes a few minutes to just even out in its heat, let's try and make some coffee. No, that was too much coffee. Let's down the voltage, down, way down. Was this just a resistive heating element, say? That should do. We can adjust our heating range on the big knob.
should have about 100 amps on the meter. There we go. Full load.
This should just take a few minutes. I might even have time to eat the pie before the coffee's done.
It's only been a couple of minutes and you can already hear the electrons are starting to move into the water.
Boiling away nicely. And much to my surprise, that kettle doesn't seem to have any positive thermal coefficient at all. The current's even slightly gone up since I started it.
I was actually expecting the current to drop a fair bit as it got up and running, but I suppose not. We can kill it there. Now, this isn't the most optimal kitchen sink, but you make do. I always fill these up to the not metal mark. This is difficult doing through a camera, but there we go, a bit extra just to cater for these special circumstances. Timer on. Give it a shake, and in 5.5 minutes, you've got your inverted coffee. And that's how you make an inverted breakfast. Cheerio.